Hello friends, I am Dr. Vinod Malkar, Professor of Marketing, and under the course of Marketing Management, I had bring the next topic to you under Marketing Planning, Control and Audit, that is Marketing Control. Control, you all of you know the marketing. Now the control means to verify and check the actual performance with the planned one. According to Philip Kotler, marketing control is the process taking steps to bring actual results and desired results closer together. So friends, as a professor, if I had decided the target of my course result is 90%, then I have to control it by various measures. So at the end of semester, I will not measure it whether my results has been achieved. Whether my target is going as per the way, I have to make certain control points. So there might be assessments in between the end semester examinations and these examinations, and we'll have a various control measure. So like that, marketing, if you have a marketing plan, then to achieve that plan, to achieve that target, there is a need of the control. So marketing is one of the crucial functions of an organization. Therefore, the management must exercise proper control over the marketing operations to ensure error-free results, optimum utilization of the resources, and achievement of a planned objective. This is a very important understand this marketing control loop. So the first, set the target of marketing. So like that, the sales target or brand awareness target or profitability kind of target. Measure it with an actual performance in the market. So that is very important. Again, what target you had stated and how much you had achieved that. And that is an variance whether it is a positive or negative. You just go again in the market, understand the feedback, and then in corrective taken action. So this is the marketing control loop that we should understand. Moving ahead, there are four types of marketing control. First one is annual plan control. Second one is profitability control. Third one is efficiency control. And fourth one is a strategic control. Moving ahead one by one, annual plan control. Annual plan control comprises sales analysis, market share analysis, marketing expenses to sales analysis, financial analysis, customer attitude tracking. Then under customer attitude tracking, you find customer surveys, customer panels, feedback and suggestion systems. So sales analysis, talking about first one, that is sales analysis means and sales performance analysis. So whether the targeted sales has been achieved or not. The first one is the sales managers decides what exactly they has to achieve, and then the targets has been distributed amongst various sales executives, and then it has been through reports continuously monitored whether the targets said by the executives, whether that is achieved or not, with an various types of reporting formats, that is sales performance reporting formats are there, and each heads is checking whether the sales performance is going at right direction or not. The second one is a market share analysis to evaluate the competitiveness. The management needs to find out the market share acquired by the organization. It is quite challenging to determine the market share of other organizations, but with certain data sets or some of the feedbacks, we can get an idea about the market share of your company. Then third one is an marketing expenses to sales analysis. Sometimes the firm spend much on marketing of products, which diminishes their profit margin or increases the product price. So therefore, the marketing expenses to sales ratio is calculated to know the percentage of sales value paid off as in marketing expenses. Moving ahead, there are various methods are also used, that is under an financial analysis. So financial analysis is nothing but the analysis of various ratios, that is whether that has been achieved or not. It should examine the reasons of factors which influence the rate of return and financial leverage and return on asset in the organization through financial analysis tools. Moving ahead with an customer attitude tracking, there are various methods that comes under customer attitude tracking that includes customer service. The companies get the questionnaires filled from the market, and then they will analyze that surveys and that questionnaires, and you will get in data whether the control has been done properly or not. Then customer panels. The organizations form and consumer panels where the customers are hired to review the products, advertisement and other marketing activities. It helps the management to know about the consumer perception and attitude. The next one is an feedback and suggestion system. Market performance of the products can be analyzed with the help of genuine feedback from the customer, and the same can be improved through the various inputs and suggestions getting from the market. The next, that is profitability control. There are three steps under profitability control. The first one, that is identify functional expenses. You have to identify how much of an expenses, which are the expenses heads first, that is selling expenses, distribution expenses, administrative and advertising expenses generally comes under this. Then the next step is assigning functional expenses, so that you have classified it into an marketing overheads and pure marketing expenses. Marketing overheads causing the other expenses that is related to marketing might be the persons of marketing stays in hotel, or they had rented an office in the city. So that are overheads on the marketing, that is also assigning the functional expenses. And for each function, then in the next step, prepare a profit and loss statement. So profit and loss incurred on carrying out the particular marketing activity. The third one is an efficiency control. It is very important to measure the sales force efficiency. Each person's under an sales and marketing department, that we have to measure whether that person is efficient for the working. It helps in increment, it helps in reward to these salespersons. It helps certain bonuses that has been given to an salesperson. Generally, it has analyzed with acquisitions of new customer, how much customer left from an existing customer, average cost incurred in each transaction, time invested to convert a new customer, to join a new customer, then how much of market share that particular salesperson has bring, and average sales per day. So that generally the parameter are used to calculate the efficiency of the sales force. Next one is an advertising efficiency. Advertising efficiency comprises of the first, that is awareness. How much of consumer aware about your products with the advertisement. So that is are measured from the market. Then there are various cost incurred in an promotional tools like an the advertising, sales promotion, public relation, direct marketing, various advertising campaign. Again with that the media cost, whether the advertisement has given on televisions, FM or newspaper. So entire advertising budgets, advertising cost, and return on that advertising cost is nothing but an advertising efficiency that has been calculated. So the sales before advertising and sales after an advertising, and the cost incurred in an advertising, through that the advertising efficiency is calculated. Distribution efficiency, performance of channel of distributions are measured under this, and which channels are effectively working. So comparison to the cost incurred in channel partners and the sales that channel member has been performed, with that the efficiency of the channel member is calculated, that is retailer, wholesaler, dealer, distributor, we can say. So that is nothing but the distribution efficiency. Next one is an strategic control, the marketing effectiveness rating reviews, whether the marketing campaign is becomes an effective, so that has been asked to review or rate the existing marketing plans or marketing control loops. And the last one is very important. After doing all these marketing exercise, it is very important, like an financial audit, we should do an marketing audit also. It is a systematic record which periodically examines the problem areas and provides for the means of rectification to overcome the weakness by utilizing the organizational strength and grab the current opportunities. Few significance of marketing control. Marketing control is a part of management control. It helps in management in detecting the deviations with an actual sales to an targeted sales. It helps to achieve the performance. It helps controlling wasteful expenditures. It also helps in maximizing sales force productivity. Due to this, the sales force is working hardly. Marketing control helps in directing the company to pursue best business opportunities, and it also helps in motivating sales force. Essentials of effective marketing control: set matching standard. The target should not too much high, and it should be achievable, like it is a smart, specific, measurable, achievable, realistic type of target that you have to set. Then guaranteed quick detection and prompt action. So the make and control in such a way that you very easily find out the fault, whether it is a fault of product, whether it is a fault of pricing strategies, whether it is a fault of channel of distributions or advertising or branding strategies are not working effectively. Due to marketing control, it is very easy to understand where we are. Then it should match with the organization pattern. It should be economical and it should be flexible. So if you want certain changes time to time according to the need of the market, so there is a need of flexibility also. Before designing and control marketing control system, you should remember following